was we had to find a secure way to deal with the fact that they kept messing with us and we didn't know what the time was because they were vulnerable to us and our pickets. But one of the kind of incredible things about this action was how it had legs and how passionate people were about coming out for Gaza to block the vote. People were signing up at an incredible rate. We originally designed this text alert to 75 to 200 people, maybe, and then all of a sudden we started getting endorsements from everywhere, and the loop dropped to 2,000 subscribers. And so we had to keep things dynamic. We had to keep them moving, and so, you know, of course, we had to go from 200 to 2,000, and then we had an initial day of action. But people were so fired up and passionate about what we were going out to do that they kept coming. They thought, we're going to block the vote. Yeah, we are. Every single day, people kept coming out. And so we ended up migrating a lot of things to social media. We did the 41411 text alerts, and we kept things going 24 hours a day on Twitter, amplifying autonomous calls. And what we also didn't expect from that was there was this feedback loop of solidarity and mutual aid where other Block the Vote accounts were turning up in Seattle, New York, Long Beach, all over the world. There were people blocking the vote in Spain, sending us solidarity statements from all over the world. And it's really amazing to see how this autonomous action ended up forging this amazing, like, every time that they tried to put it down, it would pop back up. And every time that the police came in posture, a new picket line would come up, the call would go out, and more people than there were before would come. So this went on for 4 days, and eventually, man, we were tired, right? But eventually, they gave up, and the threat of us being able to do that again was so much that it just postured a little. They ran from us, and I think that one of the things that's incredible is that a lot of the relationships still exist. You know, we started out trying to build a network for communication, and in the process, we built a network that if a lot of people who were around and organizing in the Bay know, that there's been a lot of mutual aid since then, a lot of coalition building since then that has gone on to do community defense, blocking ICE, all sorts of stuff like that. And I think the most watershed moment in that was when the action was, like, really firmly ended up being centered in Iraq and